Tobias Harris staying in the game after wrapping the back of his head. He collided with a camera next to the stanchion as he slid out of bounds in that last possession. And while Dwight Howard got another offensive rebound at the line on his 2-for-3 tonight.
Well, Harris' situation is vital that he's okay, mainly because during the season, he averaged 19.5 points a game, shot over 50%, great threes, over 80 on the line, second leading scorer on the team. Now, in this series, he's averaging 21 points, second behind Embiid, tied with Curry for tonight, and we can see his value because everything is off the dribble, and if he gets ahead of you, if anyone tries to double team, they make the play, and then Embiid is open.
Came into the league at age 18. Harris now in his 10th season. In the league, plays college ball in Tennessee, scores again, and he's got 16 points.
We know he's okay now. He just handled it 3/4 of the court, in and out on the dribble. That's what he saw at the opening.
Largest deficit of the entire postseason for the Atlanta Hawks right now, trailing by 22. Gallinari gets the bounce. He's got 14 off the bench. Trae Young, as you saw, is back in the game.
He's very productive, and he's in the right situation for Atlanta, coming off the bench against your second unit team, because he can score the ball, plays with a great deal of confidence.
Atlanta gets some stops to try to get back in the game with time running out. Down 20 with 8 minutes to go. Three is in and out from Thybul. Rebounded by Bogdanovich. On Trae Young, but Ben Simmons about to come back in the game, and a foul is called here on Thybul. Gallinari is going to shoot three, so a chance to get some points when the clock stops.
We have to like his game, and mainly because he's always an offensive threat because of distance. He's a good three-point shooter. Mid-range game is there. He can post up, and then he's a good foul shooter.
14 points for Gallinari so far in the game. Scan for your shot to win tickets to the NBA playoffs as well as other amazing prizes. Michelob Ultra Courtside, it's only worth it if you enjoy it. And a sold-out crowd here at State Farm Arena. First home playoff game in the conference semifinals since 2016. Atlanta got swept by LeBron James and the Cavaliers that year, went on to win the championship. Hawks made the postseason next year in 2017, lost in the first round. This is their first playoff appearance since. They beat the Knicks in the first round in 5 games and won game one in Philadelphia, dropped game two. And unless something changes dramatically here in the final 7:56, they're going to be down 2-1.
Well, you're going to see right now Simmons get back into the game with Curry, and then Harris is out there, and then plus they have Shane Milton in there along with Howard.
Harris, who's been excelling from mid-range in this game, missed the shot, rebounded by Bogdanovich. The time is now here for the home team. And look at Ben Simmons shadowing Trae Young off the ball, about 25 feet away from the goal. Here's Gallinari, gets a good look. And comes up short, rebounded by Howard.
Look, you have to be impressed with the Philadelphia defense. This has been outstanding because they've reduced the team that is an excellent three-point shooting team into only a few good looks during the course of this game. And then the fact that they're 4-for-18, that backs that up. But I like what you said about cover. They're covering at all times against your best three-point shooters. So on ball reversal, they are not open.
Three goes for Harris, his first three-point attempt of the game. He now has 19 points, seeking his sixth consecutive 20-point game of the playoffs. Joel Embiid checks back in with Howard going to the bench. Doc Rivers looking to finish strong. To your point on the threes for Atlanta, Trae Young's just got one. He's 1-for-4. So he's 2-for-11 the last 2 games after that great game one. Gonna try one from the logo. That one goes down. It isn't too late for Young and the Hawks with 6:45 to go, down 17.
Oh, you know, this Philadelphia brought MP it's lofted away.
Simmons, who's been brilliant as a passer throughout the game, grabbed by Trae Young.
Well, he had to do that.
Yep.
Because on that spin move, Simmons definitely would have made a dunk or a little baby hook.
And look, they want him to shoot. It's a side up, but the Hawks want Simmons shooting free throws. He's 3 for 6 for the game. 3 for 12 games 1 and 2. It's the 13 foul. You would imagine once they get to the point where they're in the bonus that they're going to start hacking Simmons and putting him on the line and try to pass. As Embiid catches, blocked by Capella, out of bounds, going to stay with Philadelphia, 5 to shoot.
Old-fashioned basketball, give and go. Embiid makes the pass to Simmons. Simmons is looking for going to the basket. Hit him in the painted area.
See the Kembe Mutombo. Appreciating the shot. Here's Embiid. Oh, step back three in and out. Rebounded by Collins. The shot clock was winding down there, so Embiid had to put it up. Midway through the fourth. Young feeds Capella. Oh, Embiid goes down hard. Capella will go to the line. Embiid still down for Philly. We saw him land awkwardly on two occasions earlier in the game. He's helped up and will stay on the floor.
Well, I'm glad to see that he's moving, right? And the big thing, he gets caught up in the air. And that's dangerous when you're a 7-footer, 270, 280, and if you're landing on a hip area. Oh, right there at the back.
Capella, only a 57% free throw shooter. Again, Embiid staying on the floor. Capella gets the bounce on the second one, so it's a 16-point lead for the Sixers.
Once again, we'll break out the point. It's not impossible. We have 6 minutes. Can you pitch a shutout defense?
This will be what it's going to take. Philadelphia has been shooting around 60% throughout the game. Here's Milton, fouled on the drive. It'll go to the line.